Alright, so yan. So, December na, mga kwentuhan. So, karamihan sa atin, nagsisimula na lang nung maging masaya dahil it's starting to feel yung Christmas season. But of course, syempre, maliban dyan, maraming nagiging masaya dahil... malapit na magbigay ng mga bonus. Like, yung iba man, baka posibleng nakuha na nila yung bonus ko yan last week ng November or itong early week nitong December na to. So, yun ang pagpukwentuhan natin ngayon. So, paano ka ba magiging matalino sa paggastos ng iyong bonus na makukuha sa iyong trabaho at para hindi na natin ma-experience, no? Kung ano yung experience natin during itong panahon ng pandemic na almost lahat ng tao ay nagkaroon ng problema pagdating sa pera or finances. So, stay put lang kayo ng pagkukwentuhan natin ngayon. So yan, so welcome back mga kwentuhan dito sa channel natin. So gaya na sabi ko kanina sa intro, ang pagkukwentuhan natin ngayon ay yung bonus o yung 13th month na makukuha natin ngayong December na to or yung nakuha na natin, no? For the past few months, especially during the first quarter ng year na to, we all experience, if not most of us experience, yung challenges pagdating sa finances dahil karamihan sa atin ay either nawala ng trabaho o na-hold pansamantali or pansamandali yung pinagkukunan ng pondo para panggastos natin our daily living, no? And now that we have an opportunity para to recover out from that problem, I'll give you some tips and share with you some techniques or strategies maybe that you can utilize so that we can avoid, para maiwasan natin yung problem or yung sitwasyon na encounter natin during the pandemic situation, no? So I'll give you 4 techniques or 4 ways on how you can be smart para maging matalino sa paggastos ng iyong 13th month or yung bonus na makukuha mo sa trabaho mo ngayon. Pero before natin simulan yan, if this is your first time in my channel, mga kwentuhan, so please help, please lang, no? Mag-subscribe ka na sa channel ko and click mo na rin yung like button or pati yung notification bell dahil I'm sure marami kang matutunan dito sa channel ko, all related sa fitness and health. At if you wanted to add knowledge or dagdag kaalaman pagdating sa financial education also, no? So, please subscribe and click that notification bell. Alright? Okay, umpisahan natin. So, paano mo nga ba magagamit ng matalino o wise yung perang matatanggap mo ngayon na bonus or 13th month? So, I'll give you 4 ways that you can be smart on how you should be able to spend wisely yung 13th month or yung bonus mo, no? I personally don't recommend, and I'm sure most, if not all financial advisors as well, or financial practitioners in the market, in this industry right now, will definitely tell you that you will not, or you're not supposed to be spending all of it. At syempre, hindi rin naman namin ina-advise na isave mo rin lahat yan, no? Syempre, as much as possible, you also want to enjoy yung benefit, yung happiness na makukuha mo with the money that you will be getting. Alright? So, let's start with first. Ano ba yung pwede mong magawa? So, number one, kagaya na sabi ko kanina, na-experience natin yung financial problem. All of us, if not most of us, experience that. And for us to avoid that problem again happening in the future, because just like what you know, problems or emergency like that can happen, definitely will happen. Hindi lang natin alam kung kailan siya mangyayari. So for us to be prepared for that, kailangan natin mag-set up ng emergency fund, no? So ano ba yung emergency fund, Alvin? Parang either yung iba sa inyo nakarinig na kung ano yung emergency fund na yan, or posible yung iba ngayon lang maririnig. So simple lang naman yung emergency fund, no? Magkaiba to sa savings account na meron kayo. From the term itself, emergency fund, so you just simply are going to put money, a percentage. In the financial industry, they would usually say 2 to 3 months worth of your monthly salary should be equivalent sa emergency fund nyo, as a rule of thumb, no? But of course, kailangan lang is meron kang buffer. No, at least that would make you survive yung daily living mo and your family kung dumating yung situation na mawalan ng trabaho. So kaya tinatawag na emergency fund. And dun mo yan siya kukunin pag dumating yung sitwasyon na to. Now, when I say emergency fund, this is your emergency fund for yourself and your family. Hindi mo dapat kukunin dito pag meron sa iyong kaibigan, pamilya, o sino mang malalapit mong kaibigan na humihingi or umuutang ng pera pag humihingi ng tulong. Hindi mo yan siya dyan kukunin, makakwentuhan. So just please take note of that, okay? So number one, you need to start setting up your emergency fund. Second, this is the second item, pero I think this should go first, which is yung kailangan meron kang savings also, no? Itong savings na to dapat easily accessible sa'yo o yung tinatawag nating liquid, no? Some of us would either put it aside sa bahay lang para mabilis ma-access, pero there are people na very challenged pagdating yung readily available yung pera pag nandito lang sa same sa loob ng bahay nyo. So some people would either really put it in a savings account sa banko for them to easily access it anytime that they want. Now, the only problem with that is, kagaya na sinabi ko kanina, we have to be smart in creating using yung fund na makukuha natin, yung 13th month pay. So, since matutulog yan sa banko, syempre, kaya gusto natin, as much as possible, mag-earn siya ng pera kahit papano, no? Pero nowadays, ang interest rate of your savings account in the bank per year, or per annum, as we call it sa jargon, is usually less than 1%, if not mga 0.5% na lang yata ang kinikita, no? But again, I can be wrong, but what I know for a fact is it's just really gonna be less than 1% per year, ang interest rate. So, I would recommend these two things that you can do, where you can put your money as for safekeeping, nakikita siya ng mas malaki compare sa mga banks, no? Number one, I'm sure familiar kayo sa application na tinatawag na GCash, no? Most of us, me ako especially, this application has been very helpful for me aside sa mga online banking application because not only it helped me pay my bills on time, online, itong GCash, si GCash also has a savings account set up as part of their services. And I'm happy to tell you that ang interest rate nila in their savings account is much higher compared to the bank. It's reaching up to 2-3%. Ulitin ko ha, 2, maximum 3% interest per year ang pwedeng kitain ng pera mo dito sa GCash na savings account. So it's much bigger compared to sa ordinary bank. So that's number one, where you can save your money. Now, ang maganda po sa GCash is wala siyang maintaining balance, no? At maliban sa wala siyang maintaining balance na kailangan kang i-prepare or i-maintain dun sa loob ng account mo, pwede mo rin siya ma-access anytime, kagaya ng savings account. Second, I would recommend that you start saving money also sa application, yung ING na application. So, it's an international savings online banking application or platform that is available in worldwide, in almost 40 countries worldwide. And they have higher interest savings rate also compared to the normal banking. So based from the last research that I have done, it ranges from 1 to 2% higher than the normal bank savings account na meron tayo dito sa Pilipinas. So those two application you can start to save. You may want to start doing your own research also. If you wanted to know more about these two application, you wanted to ask questions about it, just put some comments down below and I'll try to answer it as much as I can regarding your questions about these two apps. All right? So that's the second way for you to start using your money in the right way. All right? So punta tayo ngayon sa pangatlo. Ano ba yung pangatlo nating pag-uusapan para magamit mo ng matalino yung pera makukuha mo? Pangatlo is, of course, syempre, you have to start building the habit of investing also. This is the part wherein you have to ensure that your money really will grow for future use. Now, when we talk about investment, this is something that the money that you should not be touching anytime soon. So when we talk about long-term investment, usually this runs about mga 10, minimum of 10 years or more, right? So that's why you have to ensure that before you go dun sa investment side, meron kang naka-aside na savings account at meron ka rin emergency fund set in place for you to be able to avoid yung mga problems that we have experienced this year during the pandemic situation. Okay? So start building the habit of investing also. So let's go with the fourth item. So ano ba yung fourth item? So it's not enough that we set aside money for emergency fund. It's also not enough that we put money as our savings account para pwede natin ma-access for our daily expenses. Third, it's not also enough that you have yung investment portfolio. But fourth item is you need to start investing in yourself. So yan, pinaka-importante sa lahat. Because whatever you will learn as an additional knowledge in terms of managing your finances or dagdag kaalaman sa inyong financial education, anything that you add knowledge, hindi mo na yan siya mawawala. Dagdag yan siya kaalaman para sa'yo para magamit mo ng maayos yung perang kinikita mo that can definitely help you and your family benefit from it. So, add knowledge. So, yung pinakalima at pinaka-importante sa lahat, I'm sure magugustuhan mo to, and before we go there, I was talking about, you know, creating a savings account, creating an emergency fund. If you don't know how to do that, the strategy of you being able to create an emergency fund, if you don't know the strategy on how you should be able to have the right backbone, the right financial structure for you to be able to save money the right way. Yes, tama po kayo mga akwentuhan. Merong right way of saving money and setting aside money as an emergency fund. Without the proper structure and oy, Gaya, malalaglag ka na dyan. Daan-daan lang. Gaya, malaglag ka. Sandali lang mga akwentuhan. Wait lang. Yung anak ko malapit na malaglag sa ano niya, sa crib niya. Sandali lang. Okay, so yan, so game. So continue natin. So I was talking about the right structure, the right backbone, the right skeletal system that you should be, that will enable you. Yon. Medyo nabubulol na. That will enable you to be able to set aside money for your emergency fund and have the right system in place and right formula. Yon, yung tamang word. Right formula that you can use for you to have money set in place anytime that you need it, no? So yung hindi kayo mauubusan ng pera. So I have a system in place set up for that I learned from my mentors, and that's what I've been using for the longest time that I have been in the financial industry also. And that system is called Alcon's Foolproof Financial System, no? If you wanted to know more about that, just say the word Alcon. Put it in the comment section below, and I'll create a video. If not, I'll share with you a link where you can download all the information that you have for free, yung overview nun. But if you wanted to really learn the details of it, please make sure to subscribe to my channel. Join kayo dun sa membership ng channel ko, and you will see there all the step-by-step guide that can help you have that foolproof financial system and backbone that you can use starting the moment that you join the membership. Okay? So yan, sa pagkukwentuhan, i-share ko yan sa inyo doon. Just type the word Alcon and I'll share with you a link where you can get that information. or just simply join new membership. Alright, so let's go on with the fifth. Ito yung pinaka-importante at I'm sure lahat kayo magugustuhan tong fifth item na to. Alright? Now, itong fifth item is syempre, you have to enjoy yung money that you will get from it. Meaning, this is the time when you get to spend it also. Hindi lang syempre enough na para puro patagulang, no? Kailangan i-enjoy mo rin siya kasi syempre pinaghirapan mo rin yan sa isang taon, 12 months mo yan. Siyang pinaghirapan from your work. So, maganda rin na dapat i-enjoy mo siya. Pero syempre, hindi mo siya dapat ubusin lahat. So, just a portion of it, share it with your family, your friends, do some charity work also if part yan siya ng lifestyle mo. Para ma-enjoy mo rin naman siya. Okay? So mga kwentuhan, yan yung limang ways that you can spend your 13 month or your bonus the right way and the smart way. And if you did learn from this video, pakitulungan nyo naman ako. I-share mo naman ito sa mga kaibigan at sa mga kamag-anak mo para marami tayong matulungan. Okay? Hanggang susunod natin kakwentuhan. Bye-bye!